In 1905, Einstein said nothing could travel faster than the speed of light in the vacuum, and every test since then has proven him right. But what if I was to tell you there's a quantum mechanical effect where two particles any distance apart can seem to communicate faster than the speed of light? Today, we're going to be talking a little bit about quantum entanglement. Entanglement is a quantum phenomenon that links the properties of particles, say electrons, together. I can demonstrate how this works using a pair of electrons. And these tassels here are going to represent the spin of those electrons, a property that can be entangled. Now, when we measure an electron's spin, it can be in one of two positions, either spin up or spin down. Crucially, two electrons can be entangled such a way that the spin of one is always opposite to the other. Important to remember is that before we make that measurement of spin, the electrons have an equal chance to be either in spin up or spin down. Only by making the measurement do we know which one's which. So quantum entanglement comes in here. So if I was to make the measurement of this one to be spin down, it means that this one must change to be spin up. And if I was to measure this one to be spin up, it means this one must be spin down. You see, the measurement means that the other one must change. What's really weird about entanglement, though, is that these particles, these electrons, don't need to be touching for this effect to work. It still is the case that the measurement of one changes the measurement of the other one. In fact, this can happen over any distance you like, opposite ends of the galaxy, opposite ends of the universe. You'll still see the measurement of one change the measurement, the outcome of the other one. Spooky, right? Now, is it possible to break entanglement? Well, yes, the second you make that measurement, you've broken the entanglement between these two electrons. It doesn't happen again. Is it possible to re-entangle a broken entanglement between two electrons? Well, yes, you have to make them interact in some way, but you can re-entangle two electrons, and such that the measurement of one will still influence and change the measurement of the other one once again. Again, over any distance that you like. Is it possible to entangle two electrons such that their spins aren't opposite, that they are aligned, they are in the same position? Well, yes, and so you can get effects just like this. And that is quantum entanglement. So if measuring one particle's spin causes another to change, does this mean we could create faster than light communication? Let's take two people, Alice and Bob, and an entangled pair of photons, which are easier to send than electrons. Properties of photons, like electrons, can be entangled. For now, we'll use horizontal and vertical polarization. When Alice measures the first photon, she destroys the entanglement. When Bob measures the second, he gets the opposite result. If the photons start in a superposition of both horizontal and vertical polarizations, when Alice and Bob repeat this for many entangled pairs, they get a long list of opposite random results. Alice is not communicating with Bob, as all the information here is random. Although this is a massive simplification, mostly so this video isn't 3 hours long and takes me the next 2 months to edit, we do know that it isn't possible to send communications faster than the speed of light using entangled photons, but they can be used to encrypt secret messages. If Alice and Bob have pairs of entangled photons between them, they can generate results from the measurements of those entangled pairs. Using this, they can construct a key, which they can then use to scramble a message. Let's have a little look how. Let's say Alice wants to send the message 0101. Exciting, I know. Let's also say that when Alice and Bob measured the polarization of entangled photons, they managed to generate the result 0011 by assigning a 1 or a 0 depending on the polarization they received. Alice and Bob can use something called an XOR gate to scramble that original message, such that only Alice and Bob, with access to the random results of the measurements of the photons, can ever unscramble this message. An XOR gate is a fundamental operation in a digital computer. Take two zero measurements. If you were to put those inside of the gate, the XOR gate would only allow out a singular zero measurement, like so. If you were to take a one measurement and a zero measurement, or a zero measurement and a one measurement, the order doesn't matter, and put those inside of the XOR gate, you get out a singular one measurement, like so. Finally, if you were to take a set of one measurements and put those inside of the XOR gate, you get out a singular zero measurement again. That's the power of the XOR gate. This means we can use an XOR gate to take the message and scramble it from this into this. Alice can then send this message to Bob without anybody being able to intercept it, because if they do, it's a scrambled mess. They can't read it. Later, Bob can apply an XOR gate again, using the measurements of those entangled photons to unscramble the message and recover what Alice was trying to send. The brilliance about the system is that as you've used entanglement to send that key over from Alice to Bob, you know that nobody else could have read it, so it must be private. Conventionally, if you were going to send the key over the post or over the internet, there's a chance that somebody could have intercepted it and therefore know your secret key and be able to unscramble your message. Entanglement ensures that your communications are entirely private. So although quantum entanglement can't be used to communicate faster than light, it can be used to send messages completely securely. If you're interested more about this exciting new topic, have a look at some of the research in the description below. But for now, from everybody here at Quantum Magic and Lancaster University, thanks so much for watching.